She introduced me to the study of viruses, and I admired the great skill with which she got the specimens. And she wanted me to calculate. She knew I, she thought I had, I knew some mathematics. That came later, but she showed me a picture of the layer lines from back, which looked curved layer lines. And these were curved in a way that wasn't just due to the misorientation of the specimen. So I worked, I figured out, and we published a paper in 55 on the splitting of layer lines into tobacco mosaic virus, because I realized this is because the screw of the helix of tobacco mosaic virus wasn't three turns in 69 angstroms, but 3.02.
Yes.
And you could then calculate and you could explain all that.
So it was split rather than curved.
Yes, they were split, but then they gave, they were the Bessel functions on the originally, if it had been an exact rational number. So I realized it was a non-integral number.
Yes.
And I think, you see, Bernal still belonged to the old tradition where it had to be, you had to have integers. It's what through you know, the very famous fiasco, it's a related subject, where Perutz, Kendrew, and Bragg tried to build chains of polypeptides,
yes,
and they only used integer helices,
yes,
because that's what he had in the crystal.
Yes.
And it's interesting, that came from Bernal. Bernal used to come and ask me,
yes,
and you may remember this, why isn't it a threefold screw axis? And I used to tell him laboriously, because if you look on the meridian, you see there's a dip in the middle.
Yes.
And you could see that on in the early pictures. But the old generation. So anyway, so I interpreted this. So after that, I began working with Rosalind Franklin. And that was about then. So by that time, then we published some papers, and she had done. And so she got some money from various people. Her work was being financed by the British Coal Producers Association, where she worked on graphite. But the X-ray tubes were all paid for. And on the side, she was doing the tobacco mosaic virus work. See, Bernal's lab was full of people doing all sorts of odd things you might call applied crystallography. And he spent time getting money from all of these things. Once the apparatus was in the lab, however, you could use them for other projects. So in the early days, Rosalind's work was
she had a grant from the Agricultural
Research. Then she got a grant from the Agricultural Research, yes, Council to work on tobacco mosaic virus.
Yes.
And when she got that grant, she could hire assistants,
yes,
or PhD students.
Yes.
And so two people turned up,
very
John Finch and Kenneth Holmes.